It sounds, Benazir Bhutto, like there's all kinds of good reasons for not doing anything.
Well, it's a very strange world. I remember when I was a student, there'd be a lot of criticism about America intervening all over the world. And now when I travel around to Asian or African countries, I often hear about why America is not intervening. Mm-hmm. So we've really come full circle. I would say that people like myself won't like to see the United States intervene everywhere, but we would like to see the United States work with other powers in determining those areas of the world where a conflict could get out of hand and become much larger. And being the sole superpower does put a special responsibility on the United States. I'm not saying the United States should send people into Afghanistan, but there is a real problem there. And we talked about vital interests. I would say it's not just democracy, it's a question of terrorism. If you look at the world, if you look at what happened in the World Trade Center, you look at what happened outside Washington, Pentagon, you see what happened in Kenya and Nairobi. It traces itself back to Afghanistan. Now, for many of us, I mean, not just necessarily Pakistan, they might say, well, this is America and Afghanistan, but it's not. Because terrorism, which is hitting the United States today, could hit other parts of the world tomorrow. Secondly, a terrorist threat on Pakistan, which is a country that's gone nuclear, and nuclear weapons falling into the wrong hands could be very dangerous. So while I'm not saying the Americans should go into Afghanistan, I am saying that there are vital interests. I'm agreeing with Senator Mitchell that one has to choose the areas. It may be Afghanistan today, it may be some other place in the world tomorrow. But America needs, in its position of leadership, to choose those areas which impact on a much larger level on global security.